अस्सलाम वालेकुम एंड वेलकम टू अब्दुल्ला पटेल इंग्लिश हाई स्कूल एंड डीआरटी जूनियर कॉलेज. लेट्स स्टार्ट बाय अवर सब्जेक्ट हिस्ट्री. एज वी हैव स्टार्टेड बाय अवर चैप्टर नंबर 4 दैट इज कॉलोनियलिज्म एंड द मराठास. वी हैव कंप्लीटेड बाय हाफ ऑफ द चैप्टर दैट इज द इंट्रोडक्शन कॉलोनियलिज्म वर्सेज द मराठा एम्पायर पोर्तुगीज एंड मराठा एम्पायर Dutch and Maratha Empire, French and Maratha Empire. Today in this session, we are going to start by new topic that is British and Maratha Empire. As I've already explained you about that Maratha Empire was the only one who very bravely faced the people who came from different country to rule India. When the foreigners came over here, when the Firangis came over here, at that time they were having two things in their hand. One was the waging scale, that is trade, for trade, and second was the Bible from which they want to spread their religion, that was Christianity. So here, let's start by our topic, British and the Marathas. Now what happened about talking about the political relation between the Britishers and the Maratha king, that is Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, began due to the Afzal Khan episode. Now there was a political relation between Britishers and Maratha king Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj only because of one episode happened, that Mughal person, that name is Afzal Khan. I hope you remember Afzal Khan. You have studied in your school section, I think. Afzal Khan episode, remember? Prior to the meeting between Maharaja and Afzal Khan, Dabol was conquered by the Maratha army. Dabol, which was the main center of Portuguese at that time. At that time, there were three ships of Afzal Khan unloading in the Dabol port. So what happened now here, Mughals were also having their hold on Dabol. So Mughal person, he is Afzal Khan, he was unloading his ship, and those three ships, he was having three ships at that time, and he was unloading the whatever the material he was having at the port of Dabol. Now see, this is the incident which has happened, Afzal Khan episode, where Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj is killing Afzal Khan. Okay, so Rajapur, Afzal Khan's son, asks Abdul Karim, the subedar of Rajapur, to unload the ships of Rajapur. The Maratha took advantage of this opportunity to attack Rajapur and conquered it. Now Abdul Karim, who had taken loan from the British, was unable to repay it. Now whatever he has asked for, who Abdul Karim has asked for loan, now he is not having in a situation of paying the loan. Whatever he has taken, he cannot repay it. So that is was the opportunity. Hence the British seized one out of the three ship, whatever the three ship what Afzal Khan was having, which were in Abdul Karim's charge, of course. Now see, the ships are of Mughals, but it is in charge of whom? Who is having that charge of those three ship? Abdul Karim, right? So of course this was an unacceptable to the Marathas, and they asked the British to return the ship. Marathas asked British to return the ship to Abdul Karim. The British refused to do so. Hence the Maratha detained Velaji. Detained means captured Velaji, the local agent of the British at Jetapur. Philip Gifford, a British officer, visited the Maratha camp to request Velaji's release, but he was also detained there. When a British officer named Philip Gifford, when he went over there, that you have to release Velaji, please. So at that time, what Marathas did, Maratha also detained himself to Philip Gifford also. Later, what happened? They released both the people. Abdul Karim also, Velaji also, as well as to the British officer Philip Gifford. However, this incident strained Bharata-British relation. Means there was no proper relationship between British and Maratha. So Maratha people were not having any difficulty in this, facing this wrong relations between, or the misunderstanding which was created between Britishers and Marathas. They don't have any bothiness. Now you can see in this slide, see some coins have been shown. Yes, these coins are the coins of the Maratha time. What a Maratha Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj was using whenever a treaty was signed at that time, whoever the opposition party will be, they have compulsory, they have to use this money only, this currency only, which was of Maratha dynasty, Maratha empire. Okay, moving further, when the Panhala fort was under siege led by Adil Shahi's army and Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj was trapped inside the fort. Trapped means captured under the fort in Adil Shahi's army. At that time what happened, it was anybody can give the gift. So there was a big box, big containers were there. So Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj very smartly, he just sat in one of the container and he was he flew away. Henry Remington, a British officer, Jefford and Vilaji were supplying ammunition, that is weapons, to Adil Shah army. They were certain that there was no escape for Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj from this situation. They were thinking like that Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj will not escape. But actually what happened, taking the opportunity, golden opportunity of those container, he sat under that container and he flew away. Who? Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. Now see, this is the Fort Panhala of Adil Shah's army. I hope the slides is visible to you people. Moving further, however, Maharaj was successful in escaping from Panhala. Next year, the Maratha defeated the British in the Rajapur campaign. Now it was like nobody can defeat Britishers. But only one empire was there, those were Marathas. As from my early starting of the chapter, I'm telling to you very bravely, fought was only one empire, that was Maratha Empire. So here, the thing that Maratha defeated the British in the Rajapur campaign. The British officer Henry Remington, Randolph Trial Taylor and Philip Gifford were arrested and imprisoned for 2 years. These three British officers, who? Henry Remington, Randolph Taylor and Philip Gifford were arrested and imprisoned for 2 years. The punishment was given for 2 years. Earlier, Lieutenant Stephen Eustick had met Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj on Raigad for obtaining permission for the British factory. Now see, whatever, maybe the Portuguese, maybe Dutch, maybe British, or maybe French. Each and everyone who want to establish their factory in the parts where Marathas are ruling, so they have to take permission. What earlier we have studied, that if they want license, they have to take permission of Portuguese. But here something reverse was happening, something opposite was happening, that they have to take permission from Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. So the same, Britishers also want to establish factory over here, so they want to take permission, they have to obtain permission from Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. Where? At Raigad. A meeting for this a meeting was held between Sundarji and Pillaji, who were the representative of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, and Eustick. Who is Eustick? It is British officer. So the meeting was arranged, but the negotiation what they have happened in this meeting were not successful, and hence the idea of establishing factory was not let down. What happened next? Henry Oxton, a British agent, was present in the coronation ceremony of Shivaji Maharaj. As we have studied the story of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, that by birth he was not a king or not a son of a king. He was son of a Jagirdar, right? So he himself has coronated. The coronation ceremony was done by himself. So at that ceremony, coronation ceremony, Henry Oxenden, a British agent, was present. He obtained a permission to open a British factory at Rajapur. he was the person who has taken the permission. Earlier also there was the people who want to take the permission from Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, but somehow that negotiation was unsuccessful. On 12 June 1674, an agreement was signed by the British and the Marathas for establishing the factory. The following terms and conditions were included in the agreement. Now, what were was accepted, what were the terms and conditions kept in front of them was that issuing permission for the British to trade in Saurajya, to open factories in Rajapur, Dabol, Chol and Kalyan. Where they have given permission to establish factories? At Rajapur, Dabol, Chol and Kalyan, at four places. Okay, then right of the Marathas to levy 2.5% octroi on the British good, etc. How much tax? 2.5%. Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj prohibited use of British coinage in the Maratha dominion. As I have already explained you in my earlier slide, the coinage, the currency, the Maratha currency was only used while trading. Maybe whoever will be the opposition party, only British coinage will be used, no other coinage will be used. So, same over here, British coinage was not acceptable in Maratha domain. He also referred it some of the conditions put by the British, such as the British goods found aloft from the wrecked ship should be returned to them. Wrecked ship means destroyed ship. So, that material, whatever the material will be found, whatever the goods will be found, so they have to return them. And the Marathas should enter a treaty with the Siddhis of Janjira. And in the same treaty it was accepted, the term and condition was kept that Marathas should enter a treaty with the Siddhis of Janjira. This clearly reveals his resolute policy of safeguarding Maratha sovereignty. Means here he was trying to secure his Saurajya. In the time after Chhatrapati Shahu Maharaj, Nana Sahib Peshwa took charge of administration. Now what happened after Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj? That was Sambhaji Maharaj. After Sambhaji Maharaj, there was Chhatrapati Shahu Maharaj. And after this scenario, after the Chhatrapati, after the Maratha, there was a new rise, there was Peshwas. So Nana Sahib Peshwa took charge of administration. The British could ensure their entry in the political affair of the Marathas as Nana Sahib. On one occasion sought help from the British. This was a mistake of Nana Sahib that one time he has taken help of Britishers. So what happened? Nana Sahib was succeeded by his second son Madhav Rao Peshwa. However, Nana Sahib's younger brother Raghunath Rao wanted to become the Peshwa. Raghunath Rao alias Raghoba approached the British for help. Alias means a nickname. Raghunath Rao, nickname Raghoba, approached the British for help. For what he has gone for help? That he want to become the Peshwa. He don't want his Nana Sahib's son Madhavrao to be a Peshwa. He just want who younger brother of Nana Sahib want that he should be the Peshwa. So he just approached to Britishers for the help. It resulted in appointing a British envoy in the Peshwa court in Pune. In 1765, the British took over the fort at Malwan. Now that was a golden opportunity for the Britishers, and hence they have taken full-fledged opportunity of attacking the Malwan fort. After the death of Madhav Rao Peshwa, his younger brother Narayan Rao became Peshwa. Moving further, in this reign the British tried to conquer Thane, Vasai, Vijayadurg and Ratnagiri. In North India, the Mughal Empire was under the protection of Shinde and Holkar. By this time, the British had become active to get the custody of the Mughal Empire and to reduce the power of Bhosle dynasty of Nagpur in Bengal. So, at the same time, Britishers were also having their hold on North India also, where North India Mughals were there and they were under the protection of Shindes and Holkers. And at the same time, the Britishers have become an actor to get the custody of Mughal Empire and to reduce the power of Bhosle dynasty, which was on the edge of Nagpur in Bengal. Now see, overall, they want to have their hold. For the British to bring the region from Shasti Vasai to Konkan under their sway means rule, was a priority for trading operation. Their main interest was of trading, earning profits. So they were already planning and moving in that direction. Raghunath Rao Peshwa was offered asylum by the British. The British army marched from Mumbai to Pune with Raghunath Rao Peshwa in their escort. Now this thing was happening here. Raghunath Rao, who want to become Peshwa, he was helping to Britishers as he want to become a Peshwa. So here he was against the Maratha Empire. The British army and the Maratha army met at Talegaon, Vadgaon near Pune and had a combat between them. The British army and of course Raghunath Rao also was defeated by the Marathas. Again, see, there was a war between them, and here again who won? Marathas. A treaty was signed again over here, and the treaty which was signed was called as Vadgaon Treaty. Later Nana Fadnavis formed an alliance. Alliance means friendship, friendly relation of four rulers, namely Peshwa, Bhosle of Nagpur, Nizam and Haider. Peshwa, Bhosle of Nagpur, Nizam and Haider. These were the four group of alliance, that is a friendship alliance was formed by whom? Nana Fadnavis. However, the British successfully persuaded the Nizam to break the alliance. British, whatever will be the way, each and every way they have tried to break this alliance, the friendly relation of the four. All through this happening, the British governor Warren Hastings had realized that if the British had to establish their permanent rule in India, it was crucial to subdue the Marathas. Now it was realized by British governor, who was the governor at the time? Warren Hastings. He realized at the time that now if Britishers want to have permanent settlement in India, so what they have to do, it is very crucial. It is next to impossible for them only because of the Marathas. Hence, in the Battle of Kharda, that is Taluka Jamkhed, District Ahmednagar, the Maratha army had a sweeping victory over the Nizam. The British envoy who was present in the Maratha camp could minutely observe and study the military tactics of the Marathas. Later, with the help of this envoy, Lord Wellesley could defeat the Marathas. Now, already Marathas were in front of everyone, and it was confirmed to each and everyone, maybe the Indians or maybe the British, that Marathas are the most powerful, most bravest army, and they are not going to have defeat. So each and everyone was having like, we have to give a defeat to Marathas. So not only Warren Hastings, but also another person was also that Lord Wellesley. He has also kept an eye on Marathas, and minute details was seen what are the tactics which were used during the war by Marathas. Each and everything was kept in mind, and later on this was the most important part in their war to defeat the Marathas. Nana Fadnavis died during this time of Bajirao Peshwa II. The relation between Holkar and Bajirao Peshwa II had turned bitter, means it was opposite. Now there was no friendly alliance. As a result, Yashwantrao Holkar attacked Pune. This was the result that Yashwantrao Holkar attacked Pune. Bajirao Peshwa II panicked and sought asylum from the British. Now, as he was feared that now each and everything is going in vain, so what will happen? So he panicked, means he got feared, and he sought help from the Britishers. The treaty signed by the British and Peshwa after this incident is known as Treaty of Versailles. However, this treaty was not acceptable to Shinde and Holkar. Hence, there was another Anglo-Maratha war. Anglo means British. British and Maratha war. Another war had taken place in the year 1803. In this, what happened? Marathas were defeated finally. Now, then again there was a third Anglo-Maratha war. Anglo-British. British and Maratha war was fought in the year 1817, and again Marathas were defeated. And hence, in the year 1818, Maratha rule came to an end. Bajirao Peshwa was granted an annual pension by the British as he has taken help from Britishers, right? So he was granted an annual pension by the British and he spent rest of his life in Betur near Kanpur. Now we have completed by our topic, that is British and Maratha Empire. Let's have a quick revision of the topic. Some important points I'm going to say you about this topic, just have marking in your test book. The first point that we have to remember is the political relation between Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj and the British began due to the Afzal Khan episode. Second point, later the Fanala fort was seized by Adil Shah's army and Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj was trapped inside the fort. However, Maharaj was successful in escaping from Panhala. Third point, next year, the Marathas defeated the British in the Rajapur campaign. Fourth point, earlier, Lieutenant Stephen Eustace had met Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, but the negotiation in this meeting were not successful. Fifth, Henry Oxenden obtained the permission to open a British factory at Rajapur. Sixth point, on 12th June 1674, an agreement was signed by the British and the Marathas. Seventh point, Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj followed resolute policy of safeguarding Maratha sovereignty. Eighth point, after Chhatrapati Shahu Maharaj, Nana Saheb Peshwa, followed by his son Madhav Rao Peshwa, took charge. However, Raghunath Rao wanted to become the Peshwa. Ninth point, Raghunath Rao asked for British help and a British envoy was appointed in the Peshwa court in Pune. Tenth point, in 1765, the British took over the fort at Malwan. 11th point, after the death of Madhav Rao Peshwa, his younger brother Narayan Rao became Peshwa. 12th point, the British army and the Maratha army fought at Talegaon, Wadgaon, and the British army was defeated by the Marathas. Wadgaon treaty was signed. 13th point, later Nana Fadnavis formed an alliance of four rulers, but the British successfully persuaded the Nizam to break the alliance. 14th point, in the Battle of Kharda, the Maratha army defeated the Nizam. 15th point, when Yeshwantrao Holkar attacked Pune, Bajirao Peshwa too panicked and sought asylum from the British. Treaty of Versailles was signed. 16th point, Second Anglo-Maratha War, Anglo remember British, British and Maratha War in the year 1803 was held. The Marathas were defeated in this war. 17th point, the Third Anglo-Maratha War was fought in 1817. The Marathas were again defeated and the Maratha rule came to an end in the year 1818. 18th point, Bajirao Peshwa was granted an annual pension by the British and he spent rest of his life in Betur near Kanpur. Here I end by the revision. These were the important points that you have to remember in the topic British and Maratha Empire. Okay. So till then, next session, stay at home, stay safe. Thank you so much for listening.